Welcome to this video on the Bullish Marubozu. In this video, you will learn more about a trending bullish candlestick pattern named Bullish Marubozu and interpret the rationale behind the pattern. On your screen right now, there is one candlestick. It's a green candlestick. Just to refresh your memory, this becomes the open, this becomes the close. And since there are no wicks over here, the open also becomes the low of the day, and the close also becomes the high of the day. How would you interpret this candle? For that, let's think about how the candle was formed. Given this is our open, and this is the close, the price started from here. The price went up in the day. There must have been some sort of small correction. But in general, the prices would have kept going up. Again, there must have been some corrections. The correction may or may not have broken the previous low. However, whenever the price went up, it broke the previous high. This continued till day end, till the closing price. One thing you need to note over here is the price never went below the open and closed at the high of the day. That is, the open became the low and the close became the high. This is how you actually got a candle that does not have any kind of wicks. Now, can you tell me what this candle signifies? Clearly, it signifies extreme bullishness in the market as the price kept on rising. Whenever resistance was faced, and sellers tried to take over, buyers came back with even more strength. As a result, the day started from open and closed at the high without actually creating any type of wicks. Now that you understand the first candle over here, can you interpret the second and third candles? Let's try to do it logically. The second candle opened on a strong bullish note and the price never went below the open. Therefore, the open was equal to the low. Throughout the day, the candle showed strength. It showed some corrections but still went up. But towards the end of the day, after going to a certain top, the price corrected a bit. That is, there was some kind of correction towards the end of the day and buyers couldn't counter that. You might be dicey with respect to whether or not bullishness will be seen once again in the next candle. In the same manner, if you analyze the third candle, the day started a bit weak and the price went below the open. But during the day, the buyers again took over the sellers and the day closed at day high. The close was equal to the high. You would again expect this type of bullish sentiment to carry forward to the next time frame. These types of candles, which either have no wick or a very small wick, are called Marubozu candles.